Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Blind? That's quite a mouthful. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We have named a character and attributed stats and abilities and all this such. We're finally ready to start playing the game, or at least watching the intro for now. Exit with your changes. So the interesting thing here is there's a clock that says Zaphod on it. I don't know if that's an actual... in the intro coming. I don't know if that's an actual clock company or if that's a nod to Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Seems kind of odd a vampire game to be making a nod to Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, but it's just something I noticed. And there's something else I noticed that's like confused me at first, but what happens in the room anyway, you will basically... Yeah, it'll be explained by the man who speaks afterwards. So, let's check it out. The Embrace. The act of transforming a mortal into a vampire. Stay tuned to see how that happens. Actually, I don't know why there'd be condoms in this case. There's a clock. And that's me. And because we chose the homosexual background or history, that's why you have two females.
Good evening. My fellow kindred, my apologies for disrupting any business or interfering with prior engagements you may have had this evening. It's unfortunate that the affair that gathers us together tonight is a troubling one. We are here because the laws that bind our society, the laws that are the fabric of our existence, have been broken. As prince, I am within my rights to grant or deny the kindred of this city the privilege of siring. Many of you have come to me seeking permission, and I have endorsed some of these requests. However, the accused that sits before you tonight was not refused permission. Indeed, my permission was never sought at all. They were caught shortly after the embrace of this child. It pains me to announce the sentence.
That neck, though.
Up to tonight, I considered the accused a loyal and upstanding member of our organization. But as some of you may know, the penalty for this transgression is death. Know that I am no more adjudicator than I am a servant to the law that governs us all. Let tonight's proceedings serve as a reminder to our community that we must adhere to the code that binds our society, lest we endanger all of our blood. Forgive me. Let the penalty commence. Which leads to the fate of the ill-begotten progeny. Without a sire, most child are doomed to walk the earth never knowing their place, their responsibility, and most importantly, the laws they must obey. Therefore, I have decided that...
This is bullshit!
Nines.
If Mr. Rodriguez would let me finish.
But nines, Rodriguez.
I have decided to let this kindred live. They shall be instructed in the ways of our kind and be granted the same rights. Let no one say I am unsympathetic to the plights and causes of this community. I thank you all for attending these proceedings, and I hope their significance is not lost. Good evening.
You can see quite a number of clans present here.
Your sire. Tragic. My apologies. But you see, there is a strict code of conduct that all of us must adhere to if we wish to survive. When someone, anyone, breaks these laws, they undermine the well-worn fabric of our centuries-old society. Understand my predicament. Allowing you to live makes me directly responsible for your subsequent behavior. So, what I'm offering is not generosity, but the opportunity to transcend the fate woven by your sire. This is your trial. You will be brought to Santa Monica. There, you will meet an agent by the name of Mercurio. He will provide the details of your labor. I've shown you great clemency. Prove it was more than a wasted gesture, fledgling. Don't come back until you do. Good evening.
Not only do vampires hide from mortals, they hide from themselves as well, pretending they are not the horrors that they have become. Okay, so I've changed these keys. Well, pretty self-explanatory. Effect gained, healing rate, duration. Okay. So basically he explained... Did he explain it? I'm not sure he did. So what happened is that... Oh, this guy explains it. Never mind. The guy we're going to talk to in a second explains that... Well, you think that when you... Well, in some fiction, if you stab a vampire in the heart with a stake, they're dead. So it's not quite the case here. And here's, this guy's going to explain it all. So you've got jump. You've got sneak. You've got basically basic combat, blocking. What else do I have? I have basically reload and holster weapon, which I don't have a weapon right now. What else do I have? We got inventory. Wallet. Your cash. $0. Your wallet is empty, baby. You're so broke, you can't even afford to pay attention. Gotta love that. And then key ring. Your key ring contains these keys. No keys. Okay, so here we've got fists. No weapon ready. Here's our brawl combat requirement. And such. I'm not even sure what would be here. Light clothing. This is the most basic and unrestricted clothing. Examples would be t-shirts, khakis, sundresses, and pleated skirts. What if I go use? Can't use. And then a wallet. Okay. And then you've got the character menu. We need to get back here. What else? Actually, F1 is your melee weapons. F2 is ranged. Don't have any. So I guess that would be... That's what that menu was. And this is your armor or clothing. And then... Z is your toggle. I wrote it V here, but it's not V. And then it's by default the Z key, and then he shows your quests, which we have nothing as of yet. Info. Oh, that's cool. Star as a homosexual. Advantage thaumaturgy level 1. Dialogue dominate. Okay, so yeah, in dialogue. Can raise no physical attribute above 4. So that's your info sheet, and then quest log, and get into here. And then what else? We've got feed, which I'm going to show you shortly. That's it. Oh, hotkey menu. I'm not going to mess with this just yet. I will in a few minutes, so. And that's really it. We're gonna go talk to this guy. Can I turn that off? How do I turn that off? Here we go. So on the left you see the blood. That's the amount of blood that I have, and whenever I use special abilities and such, it uses up the blood. And then here we have different... I don't even know how you switch between them. I'm going to be using the, what do you call it? The hotkeys, basically, for that. So, and then on the left, I believe that's your hit points, and then this gun showing at the top means you're in an area where you can fight. So basically, this is not a area dominated or characterized, whatever, what have you, by the Masquerade. Otherwise, instead of this gun here, you would have the Masquerade, you know, sad face mask. And then if there's an E on top, that's Elysium, which is no combat is allowed. Combat doesn't occur. That's such a thing. So that's that. And then if you go into sneak here, it adds next to here, you see added next to the blue hit point bar, that's your light. Once you get into more lit areas, the little ruler fills up more. The zero number there basically means no one can see you. If it's 100, you're seen. And then everything in between is a variation, of course. So, yeah, a little 101 stuff that I've just learned myself, and I'm passing on to you who might wonder. So let's talk to him.
What a scene, man! Woo-wee! Then they just plop you out here like a naked baby in the woods. How about that? Look, kiddo, it's probably a lot for you to take in, so why don't you let me show you the ropes? What do you say?
So the interesting thing about this character, I don't know about any of the other characters, but I just happened to look because I have played this part, and a little further than this, and then the rest is blind, but since I have played this, his voice sounded really familiar, and I don't know if it should sound familiar to me. It basically sounds kind of like Wolfman Jack, and that's where I might, you know, old disc jockey, Wolfman Jack. But it's not him. Wolfman Jack has been dead for many years now. So this guy, actually, because I looked it up, he does a voice or two in the... think of I can't think of the game. The game I haven't played. Oh, Gears of War. All right, he's done a voice or two in one or more Gears of War games. But also, funnily enough, he does the voice of Bender in Futurama. That's right, Bender in Futurama, same guy. If you listen to it, you can hear how he would. It kind of sounds a little similar, but he changes his voice around. But anyway, who are you?
I'm Jack. What's important is I'm offering help. You make it back from Santa Monica with your hide, and we'll trade life stories, okay? Till then, I got about this much time. You in or out?
What happened in there?
Don't worry, kiddo. You'll adjust. I'd love to explain it all, but time's a-wasting. You want some help or what?
Yeah, I kind of wish his voice was a little louder, but his voice is a lot lower than the Ventru, who's the prince. His voice was higher, so I gotta make it so you guys can hear me over the voices, so... I might adjust the volume at some point. Unfortunately, the volume is just all one slider, so... all the voices, music, sound effects are all in one volume, so it's really all I can do. Anyway, okay, I could use the help. So if you choose three, I'm assuming you're skipping the tutorial.
All right. Why don't we step out back here?
Now, I'm not sure what he means, step out where. Because the only option is, I like it where I am. At least I'm out of that theater.
Much better. Now,
We ain't got much time, but I figure somebody should fill you in on the bare bones stuff at least, you know. Could save your hide. You look wobbly. You even had a drink yet?
Now I know what he means, and anybody that knows anything to vampires knows what he means by a drink. But I'm a little naive, so drink of what?
Oh man, we're popping a cherry here! Ha ha ha! Ah, you're gonna love this. Alright, check it out. Blood, it's your new rack of lamb, your new champagne. Blood, your new fucking heroin, kid. Get ready though, cause hey, it's never as sweet as the first time.
What do I do?
Well, down around the corner there, I saw this human. Poor SOB can't find his car.
So, what do I mean,
Alright. You go down there, casual like. You creep up on him, then bare those little fangs and feed. Don't worry if you weren't captain of the wrestling team or something. Because it'll come so naturally, you think you've done it 1,000 times already.
Won't he become a vampire then?
Forget that comic book crap, kid. It don't work that way. Now go for it. Be sure, though, and this is important, so listen up. Be sure not to drain him dry, okay? It might be hard to resist, but don't kill him.
Quest log updated. Alright. This is the blood pool, yeah. Blood is the fuel for your vampiric powers or disciplines. When your blood is low, you need to refill it. Humans are an abundant source of blood in most areas of the game. One is in the alley around the corner. So anyway, can we talk to him more?
Go on. I'll be right here. Okay.
So you can look at stuff. I don't know if these textures look better to anybody who's familiar with the game, but supposedly updated the bricks, the ground, and such like that. Now, he told me to walk up casual, but I'm not sure if you're supposed to sneak. When I did it, you sneak. So as you're getting closer to the light pole, you can see the gray bar on the left-hand side filling up. And then as you get into the shadows, yeah. But this guy is like completely oblivious. He's still zero. He can't see me at all. Feeding on humans fills your blood pool. To feed, approach your victim. Place the feed key when you're close. It's important that humans do not see you feed on other humans. Yes, breaking the masquerade by that. Once you've begun feeding on your victim, you will see this bar appear. This represents your victim's blood pool. You should stop feeding before emptying his blood pool and killing him. Press feed again, stop feeding. So I think most characters are not going to be like this because I'm standing right next to him. I'm not good in sneak and we got zero here. And I'm like standing right in front of him. So much he's probably bumping into me. So now I'm feeding. If you get hit or injured while you're doing this, you break off and it stops. So let's let him go, otherwise we'll kill him. Then if we kill him, we lose some humanity. So he's in a trance for a little while. And that's that. Yeah.
Yeah, you're feeling it. I can see it in your eyes. You're a born-again predator. Feeling that blood bubbling inside you, lifting you up. That's it, kid. That's what it's all about right there.
Yeah, it feels amazing. You could live all your life and never feel anything like this. So, pretty indescribable. But yeah, I'm feeling pretty exuberant right now with all this blood. I feel completely energized, like that stronger than I've ever been. So great. When do I get my cape? Do I get to pick the color?
All right now, you got the blood, you're feeling all kick-ass, feeling better than your best day living, but wait, it gets better. All kindred, that's a our word for vampire, all kindred have a few things in common.
things that set them right square above humans on the food chain.
Yeah? Like what?
Like sharper senses, a body that can take a beating, and if you play your cards right, eternal life. That's no sure bet, but still, a chance at immortality is not a bad deal. And that's just for starters. Fringe benefits for joining the club.
So I'm going to live forever?
Well, you can still be destroyed, but forget the books and the movies. Garlic? It's worthless. A cross? Pfft, shove it right up their ass. A steak? Only if it catches you in the heart, and then it just paralyzes you.
See that?
Running water? That's no problem. I bathe. Occasionally. Now, a shotgun blast to the head? Oh, that's trouble, boy. Fire? That's real trouble. Sunlight? Well, you catch a sunrise and it's all over, kiddo. Get it?
So, yeah. That's why I was confused the first time I played through this and saw the intro. Is because you figure those two vampires are dead. Including, you're not sure if that's you when you start out with. But yeah, it turns out it is you. And no, it doesn't kill you. It paralyzes you. And then once you remove the stake, ta-da, you're unparalyzed. So that's how they paralyze, you know, me and my sire, the one who turned me, and basically brought us to the stage where you saw us, and then took the stakes out, and we were unparalyzed at that moment. So yeah, got it.
Okay, now. The fuck is this?
I like the hiss.
Look, you get inside here.
You do that. So at the bottom of your screen is a use icon. This icon appears when you're able to use the object in front of you. Press the use key to use the object that it indicates. The icon is context sensitive. It will look different depending on the object you can use. In this case, a door that can be opened. Or talk to him. Meet you in there.
I'll meet you in there.
So, ta-da, he's gone. How do you do that? So this guy is still here, I think, as well. But if I feed on him, I'll probably kill him right away, or almost. So we're not going back in here. We're going in here, then. So, we can pick up things, certain things, throw them. At least in that case, not the great effect. Press the jump key to jump. Jump on the boxes against the wall up to the walkway above. Now, I wonder if I hold this longer. Hold on a second. Nope, it launches as soon as I... Oh. I'm used to the F key for changing stuff. So, these I can't pick up. There's a couple barrels you can pick up, but so what? Well, the jump is a little janky. Your feats are the combinations of your various abilities and attributes. The higher your feats scores, the better you are at the activities they influence. Inspection is a feat. It's a combination of perception and investigation. We'll have a bonus ranks in any of those. It allows you to see hidden and secret things, for example, the lockpick on the crate in front of you. You can find your feats listed on the right-hand side of your character sheet. Indeed. You can pick up certain objects in the world, blah blah blah, use icon, crosshairs, use key. So we can pick this up. Item gained. So here, Jihad for beginners, huh? Head inside the building, meet Jack upstairs. So we don't have a quest in anywhere else. Lockpicks. Tool of the trade for locksmiths and burglars. A lock pick is used to push the pins inside a lock into their correct position until the lock is open. It takes a lot of experience to use these well. So here we come to the limits of what I've played. This is all I've done. Basically stood here, I have not approached him, so everything from now on is blind.
Come down here. Stay away from the windows.
You're by the windows.
Oh, it's a Sabbat raid. The Sabbat, they're, Christ, I was hoping to spare you this shit till later. The Sabbat, well, they're mostly mindless, bloodthirsty assholes. That's all you need to know for now, all right?
Yeah. So, they're another group of clans, like the Camarilla, who is the group of clans that looks over us. Which I'm assuming the Ventru are the head clan. Or at least they would like to be thought of as such. So, what's up?
The Sabbat got wind of the gathering here, so they figured they'd raise a little hell and put a little heat on the new prince.
The guy from the intro, yeah. So he's talking about the guy who was speaking at the intro, then. What's the prince a prince of?
No time for political rundown. Job one, get out of here alive. Sabbat might be mindless, but they hit like a Mack truck, like raging savages. Nothing a fledgling like you wants to mess with.
Good, because I don't feel like messing with them, so what am I supposed to do?
Shh. Heads up. Back away.
Oh my. We're just gonna watch this. He was on stage next to the prince. Awesome. Are those Gangrel feeding on them? Oh wow. He's awesome, this guy. Okay, I look weird the way I'm standing like that. But he noticed me.
Dumb, frenzied Sabbat bastards. All right, we gotta vamoose out the back quick. I'll stay and keep a watch out. You get us into the office. The door's around the corner here.
I'm on it. So access your quest log. Press the quest log key. Information about your quest. Notes and instructions you'll need to complete them. Blah, blah, blah. Quick save. A vicious vampire faction known as the Sabbat has launched an assault on the secret Camarilla gathering downtown. You and Jack are caught in the middle. To escape, you must obtain entry into the office. I think it really was modeled after Wolfman Jack, because they called him Jack. He sounds a lot like him. Alright, Jack's gone. So, I think I should sneak. We're supposed to get into somewhere. Not here. Guessing we're gonna have to pick this lock. Yep. When a door is locked, you'll see this use icon. Lock picking is a combination of dexterity and security, which I have a rank in each. A feat that helps you to open locked doors with a lock pick. Press the use key to try and lock pick it. Once you have begun lock picking, you will see this bar. It represents the time needed to pick the lock. If the value of your lock picking feat is equal to or greater than the difficulty of the lock, you'll be able to pick it. Since we have ranks, I don't think it's going to be that much of a challenge. Okay, why is it not working? Do I need to have the lockpick equipped or something? Okay, that's my use key. Okay, I punched it. Not sure why it's not working. Maybe we can't be in sneak? That doesn't make sense, though. Ah, okay. Lockpicking succeeded at lock difficulty of 1. Okay, so I figured it would be like a mini game or something like that, like Skyrim. You have to, you know, figure out the correct combination of where to put the pins, but no, it's just automatic. At least so far, anyway. So I have to get out of sneak to do that, which doesn't make sense. Why can't we sneak to open doors? It's weird. I thought I was getting you in. You're already here. Takeout menu. What we got here? Not really legible. That's gonna be annoying doing that. Well, I guess it's not even trying because I don't have lockpicks. Let me know if you want me to try to install the furniture mod. It updates the textures on furniture. There's not a whole lot of texture mods. There's a reskin for my character that basically takes off the glasses and such, but I'm not sure if it's an increase in texture or just a reskin, you know, basically the same texture, just, you know, different stuff, like without the glasses. Registrations and licenses. Oh, you can grab this? Okay.
Shortcut. Well, nicely done, though. Not exactly an angel in life, were you?
Who, me?